So I'd like to explain to you how life works, at least from a comedian's perspective. First, there's a setup, and then there's a punchline. See, your setup is your talents, your resources, and your opportunities. And most of the time, we use our setup to ensure that the people around us are moving in a direction that serves us, which means the punchline occurs when you change that direction in a way they're not expecting. You actually use your setup for other people. The results are the same, yet multiplied. It's revelation, it's fulfillment, and it's joy. But it's not just for the one receiving your punchline. It's also for you who get to deliver the punchline as well. If I asked the question, what is your setup? Chances are all of you would be able to tell me. Because your setup is the fact that you got a house, you got a car. Your setup is about what you receive. But what if I asked you the question, what is your punchline? Because your punchline is about what you're called to deliver. And if you know your setup, which we all do, but you don't know your punchline, you'll realize that something's missing. And what you'll try to do to fill that void is you'll think you need more setup. But what you really need to do, you need to know what is your punchline. And please understand, just like me struggling with my reading as a child, your setbacks are part of your setup so you can deliver the punchline you're called to deliver. Much like a slingshot, the further you've been set back, the further you're going to reach. But what are you going to aim for? Listen, the three stories that I shared you this evening are simply about people just like you. They've used their setup and their setbacks to deliver their punchline to somebody that needed it. So we were in Nashville doing a show. And whenever I'm doing comedy, I'm trying to listen in between the jokes. And what I'm listening for is there's a question that I'm asking, and I'm asking the question, what can I give to this audience now? What does this audience need? Now listen, you have an audience too. And you also have jobs and careers, and you also have some gaps. And if you would just simply start asking the question, what can I give to the people around me, it'll change the whole game. So I'm in Nashville, and I'm listening between the gaps, doing the jokes, and I feel like I'm supposed to talk to this lady who was in the front row off to the side. But the lady's deaf, and I don't know no sign language, but there's a sign language lady up there, right? I mean, I don't know. Only sign language I know is that's all I got, that's all I got, right? So I'm listening between the gaps, and I feel like I'm supposed to talk to this lady. So I asked the sign language lady, I said, hey, can you ask her to come up on stage, please? And the whole crowd kind of froze. Like, they don't know what's going on. She don't know what's going on. I don't know for sure what's going on. So I say, hey, can you just ask her to come up on stage? So she signs to her, and a lady comes up. She's really, really shy. It's a white lady, maybe 53 years old. She comes up, and then I said to the sign language lady, I said, can you ask her, what is her biggest need? And she signs over and she signs back and she says, she doesn't have any needs. She says she's okay. I was like, nah. I said, ask her what is her biggest need. And then she signs back and she says, well, her and her husband haven't been able to go on vacation together in over 13 years. And they just need a weekend or something away. I was like, okay. Now normally you would just stop right there, get some money, and then, da-da, we're done. But no. I just asked the next question. I said, why not? And then she said, well, she did the sign language thing, came back, signed. And she said, well, they have a special needs child, and they can't afford anyone who can take care of the child in a way where they feel comfortable and they can leave. I was like, okay. So I turned to the audience, and I said, where is the special needs nurse who can deliver their punchline? And the room is silent. They're still in shock. I'm in shock. We all kind of tripping. So nobody said anything. Then I said, where is the special needs nurse who can deliver the punchline? And you hear a voice come from the balcony. And this lady says, here I am. Yo, and this lady comes walking down. And we connect them. And the whole room is done. Done. Now, if we would have just collected some money, nobody would even remember that story. But somebody showed up with their punchline ready to deliver, and somebody else was there ready to receive it. Listen, I love you. I appreciate you. Go deliver your punchline. Thank you, guys. I love you.
Yo, if you just laughed, you should like and subscribe. That's all.